Dozens of families were evacuated and classes suspended in Cati'il, Davao Oriental due to floods and landslides there. Rennel Tocmo now joins us with that story. Rennel, go ahead.
Carmina, dozens of families in the northern portion of Davao Oriental were evacuated on Sunday due to floods. Based on the report from the Provincial Disaster Risk Reduction and Management Office, the flash floods affected the towns of Boston, Cati'il, and Baganga. 30 families in Barangay Abejod and 7 families in Barangay San Antonio in Cati'il fled their homes due to floodwaters. A total of 8 barangays in Cati'il were affected by yesterday's incident. A resident, Rani Manligoy, captured videos of flooded homes, roads, and a school in Barangay San Antonio, while Nonoy Taya captured the video of flooded rice fields in Barangay Dapnan. The municipal government unit of Cati'il suspended the classes of all levels in public and private schools today, as some students were affected by a flood and some schools were also used as temporary shelters. In the town of Boston, a landslide occurred in a highway in Barangay Sibahay. However, the area was immediately cleared by some government workers. Some families in Barangay San Jose and Boston were also evacuated but later returned to their respective homes after flood water started to subside. In the town of Baganga, a flood incident was recorded in Barangay Banao and Barangay Kinablangan. The province experienced heavy rains yesterday due to effects of the presence of shear line that prompted the Weather Bureau PAGASA to issue a yellow warning level in Davao Oriental. Reporting from Davao City, Rennel Tocmo, ABS-CBN News.
Thanks a lot, Rennel. The search for the missing Cessna plane in Isabela Province now on its sixth day. Our very own Jackie Manamat now joins us with an update. Jackie, what more can you tell us?
Carmina, it has been 6 days since Cessna 206 went missing. Three search and rescue teams of the Philippine Army are already in the location, on the possible location of the missing plane at Barangay de Caruyan at the municipality of Divilacan. On Saturday, a white object was seen 4 hours away from a vantage point of a nearby barangay. However, low-lying clouds cover the area, immediately preventing officials from confirming if it is the Cessna 206. The location is also consistent with the testimony of a farmer from the Caruyan village that he saw a white object that seemed to be in distress that landed at the mountainous area of Sierra Madre. It is also within the pathway of the plains with Kawayan to Makunakon that they usually take, and the phones of the passengers were also detected in that radius. The inclement weather and treacherous hike are hampering the search and rescue efforts. Some of the rescuers have fallen ill while others were injured. The area is 1.8 million square meters surrounded by rich vegetation and rivers. Isabela PD RRMO says the search will continue whatever the terrain. Authorities are also not ruling out areas outside the Caruyan village. The relatives of the passengers are housed in a hotel in Kawayan, Isabela, waiting for updates from the authorities. And they said that they will stay in Kawayan City until their family members are found. They, however, said that they felt somewhat relieved that the rescuers are already in the location where the white object was seen. And once the weather clears, aerial search will be deployed for faster search and rescue operations. Meanwhile, residents of Makunakon are asking the provincial government to construct and repair the Ilagan-Divilacan Road as soon as possible. The safer and faster option for Makunakon residents to reach the coastal municipality is through the expensive small aircrafts from Kawayan Domestic Airport. Another option is to risk backriding a habal-habal or a motorcycle across the Sierra Madre for 4 to 6 hours depending on the weather. However, there are landslides in the area which at times blocks the motorists, and as of now, the road could not be accessed. One more option is to ride a bus or van from Kawayan or from here at Iligan to Santa Ana, Cagayan for 5 to 6 hours and then take a motorbangka for 8 to 10 hours or motorboat for 8 to 10 hours depending on the water current. The Ilagan-Divilacan Road construction started in 2016 and supposed to have been fully opened in 2020, but the pandemic and landslides delayed the projects. The mayors of Makunakon and Divilakan is in a meeting here at the provincial capital, and we will get updates on the discussion on the repair and construction of the Ilagan-Divilakan road project. Carmina.
Thanks a lot. Our correspondent there, Jackie Manaba, joining us live. Take care, Jack. Keep safe.